Students, welcome back to part 2 of tables in MS Word. So in the first video we have seen how to create tables using the first method, that is using the grids, right? Okay, so here we went to insert tab and then tables group, table arrow. Using these grids we have created this particular table, right? And also we studied about how to adjust the column width by clicking and dragging. Yes, okay. Then we also studied about how to add rows and columns and delete rows and columns. So this is what we covered in the first video. Now we are going to do the second method of adding table. Okay, now the second method. Okay, so here I want to add another table. So what is the procedure? What is the first step? First, you have to click on the place where you want to add a table. Okay, so see the cursor, it's inside this name of the student. I'm just clicking here. So the cursor has come. You know what some students will do with? The cursor will be inside. Okay, the cursor will be inside without knowing that they will go to insert tab, tables group, table arrow, and they will add a table like this. So what happens? Okay, a table is created inside the first table. Inside the first table. This is we do not want. We need a table separately. Okay, this is a common mistake students make it. That's what I'm telling you. You please don't make it. Okay, so how to remove this is I'm pressing Control plus Z key. You have to hold down the Control key and Z key together. Then the previous change what you made will be erased. Okay, that is called undo. I have done something. If you want to remove, then it is undo. The key name is Control plus Z. So far I have taught you two shortcut keys. One is to move from one cell to another cell, you have to use the tab key. Okay, then to do the undo task. Okay, removing what you have done, you have to hold on Control plus Z key. Clear, students? That's good. Okay, so let me click on the place where I need a table. Then this is the second method. Okay, go to insert tab. Okay, let me write it here. Method one, it is using grids. I have selected using grids. I have selected a table, and here let me write method two. Okay, using insert table option. Insert table option. I need a table down here. Okay, so as I said, first step you click on the place where you need a table. The second step, go to insert tab, tables group, table arrow. Okay, and just leave the grid because we have already done with the grid. So the grid has only 10 columns and 8 rows. If you want a table bigger than this, if you want to make a 12 columns and 10 rows, okay, bigger one, then you have to go to insert table option. This is called insert table option. You click here. When you click here, there is a dialog box appears. So what is the name of the dialog box? All of you read it loudly. Everyone? Yes. All of you say insert table. Repeat. Insert table. So what is the name of the dialog box? Insert table dialog box appears. In this table you can see table size, how much bigger you need a table. Okay, maybe you need a table above 10 columns or above 8 rows, or you may need it lesser. Okay, maybe 7 or 8, but you want to make it in this way. See, I need a table columns means, you know, right, vertical ones. Okay, so how many vertical columns I need is, let it be the class timetable. Okay, so if it's a class timetable, what will happen? You will be having days, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday one side, then 4 periods, then break, then another 4 periods, right? So 4 plus 4, 8, 9, 10. So I need 10 columns and rows. Rows is Monday to Friday, 5 days. And the heading one. So total 6 rows I need. Then click on OK button. Scroll down the screen to see. Now do you see the table? It's appeared. Okay. So let me write here day, this is period number 1, next to one period number 2, next to one period number 3, 4, next to one it's a break, okay, lunch break, all right. Okay, so next one 5, next to 6th period, 7th period, this is 8th period. So total 8 periods we have, got it? And here days are Monday down Tuesday. See, another thing, it's instead of using the tab key, you can use the 4 arrow keys on the keyboard. 4 arrow keys also you can use it, okay? So down Wednesday. Fine. Then down arrow, I'm using down arrow. Thursday. Then Friday. So total 5 days, okay? So Monday, whatever the class you have, maybe it's a max period, first period, second also max, third period maybe computer, okay, fourth period maybe English, okay, then lunch break, then fifth period after lunch you may have a GS, okay, then you may have a Malayalam, or you may have a Hindi period, or you may have a PT period. That's your favorite, right? Okay, so likewise you can just go ahead and type the timetable like this. Okay, so the second method is, what is the second method? Using insert table option, go to insert tab, tables group, table arrow, insert table. When you click here, what appears? Insert table dialog box. Do you see the dialog box? Here you have to enter number of columns and number of rows, then click on OK button. Click on OK button, then you will get a table. Got it? So this is another method. And in this one also, if you want to just reduce the height and width of the rows and columns, okay, what you can do is you can just keep the cursor on the column line, click and drag it. Okay, and here also click and drag it. Here also click and drag it. Okay, break is become too bigger in size, so I'm changing that also. Then class 5, sorry, 5th period, then 6th period, then see 6th period, why the line has come here, the word has come. Okay, so 7th period, after 8th period, you will be very happy to go home, right? Okay, so total 8 periods, it's over. Got it? So this is a way here you can enter the timetable whatever you have. Okay, so this is what we create a table with the help of insert table option. Okay, so this is the second method. Then third method of adding table, inserting a table. Okay, so the first step is, what is the first step? For all the methods, 3 methods, the first step it's same only. So what is this step? Yes, click on the place where you want to add a table. Okay, so I want to add it here, double click on it, then method 3, okay, using drawing table, not using drawing table. We can draw the table as we like, okay, drawing table as we like. Okay, so now I need a table over here. Okay, so where I have to go? The same tab and the same group and the same arrow. Who can tell the answer? Which tab I have to go to add a table? Yes, I have to go to insert tab and then tables group. Click on table arrow. Okay, and come down. This is already, this is the first method. Insert table, it's the second method. Then third one, it's draw table. Draw table option, okay, using draw table option. Okay, so click here, and after selecting draw table, do you see a pencil appears? You can see wherever I move the cursor, you can see the pencil. Okay, so here we are not going to draw, actually click and drag it, okay, then the table will appear. And the amount you drag it bigger, you will get a big table. And if you are dragging it in smaller size, then you will get a small table. So according to your need, you can just draw a table as you like. Okay. So see, do you see when I drag it? So you can see till the end of the page it appears. I don't want such a big table. Okay. I want to do a mark list. So okay. So this is enough for me. Okay. So and you have to decide how many rows and columns you need. Okay. So I need column serial number, name of the student. Okay. Then I need subject English, computer. Okay. Because we are studying computer, right? So we cannot leave computer. So second subject is computer. Then GS. Only three subject is enough. Okay. So for and then total marks also I need. Okay. So here, if you want, so total how many columns you need? 5 columns. Okay. So wherever you need a column, keep the pencil on the top and click and drag. When you start dragging, you will get a line. So this is the first column for serial number. We will draw first. Okay. Don't look after the size of the column. Okay. We can adjust it later. Then second one, name should be this much bigger, right? Some students have a very big name, two names, first name and second name. So I have drawn here, this is for name. Then three subject marks, okay? This is for English. Just click and drag it, okay? From the top of the place, just click and drag it. This is for computer. Then this is for GS. And this is the total marks. Or you can take two more subject, okay? English, computer, then this is GS, SS, Hindi and GK. Two more subjects I have taken. Got it? Okay, then how many rows you want? I want to make the mark list for 5 students, okay? So total 6 rows I needed because the first row will become a caption. Okay, then this is the first one. See, wherever I'm leaving, on the same place it is left. This is the second one, second row. First student, this is the second student name. This is the third student. Fourth and fifth comes here. Did you understand how I have drawn? Yes. Okay, so shall we start typing inside? Keep the cursor inside. The cursor is inside. You can start typing. What do you need? Okay, the table first column, serial number. Okay, I'm using a tab key to go to the next cell. And here, name. Okay, in the next one, English. In the next one, computer. Then maths. Do you see that automatically the columns are getting adjusted with the size? Then GS, then SS, then Hindi. Okay. So these many subjects, if you want to make it bigger, you can just make it bigger like this. As I said. Got it? Okay, so serial number, name, marks of English, computer, maths, GS, SS and Hindi. So you can just type the first student, roll number 1. Okay, name is Akshaya and marks in English. Let it be out of 100, okay. So 100, she got 90 marks in computer. Definitely you will get full marks, okay. Maths, 95. GS, 70. SS 82, Hindi 90. Okay, so this is a mark list. So similarly, you can go for number 2, roll number 2 and write the names and enter the marks and everything. So you can create a table in this way also. Got it? So total 3 methods we studied. 3 methods to create a table. So what is the first method? Using grids. Go to insert tab. Tables arrow, you have a grids here. Okay, so using this grids, you can select number of rows and column. Then what is method 2? using insert table option. Okay, so where it is, insert tab, go to table arrow, and here insert table. So when you click on a insert table, what appears? Yes, students, insert table dialog box appears. See, insert table dialog box appears, and under table size you have to enter number of columns and rows. Okay, columns and rows, then click on OK button, a table will be created. Then third method is we can draw a table. We can draw as we like by going to insert tab, tables arrow, then draw table option. Have to choose the draw table option, and you will get a pencil. You can click and drag and draw the table. Got it? And rows and columns also you have to draw. Clear, students? That's good. Okay, now let's see how to add rows and columns. I have already told you how to add. Click on the place where you need. Okay, see, it is still in a pencil. Let me change the option. Okay, so one more time I click on draw table, then the pencil has changed into a normal cursor. Got it? Okay, so who remembers how to add a row or a column? I want to add one more row here. Okay, after Friday I want to add a Saturday. So how to do it? Keep the cursor anywhere here. Okay, click here, right click, insert, and you need a row below. Below Friday I need a Saturday. So insert rows below. You can see another row it's added, and you can just type whatever you need. Okay, clear, students? Okay, then how to add a column? Actually, after second period you have a break, right? So between two and second period and third period you have a break, so that I want to add it, small break, right? So how to add it? Either you have to, if you are clicking here on 2, okay, second period, right click, insert, it's to the right side. You have to choose columns to the right. Okay, and if you are choosing third period, then right click, insert, insert to the left side. Okay, because break it's here, right? See, now two columns are added. Do we need two columns here? No, right? So what I have to do, I have to delete one column. So how to delete it? Just click, if you want to click this column, click here, or if you want to delete this column, click anywhere here, right click, delete cells. Then it comes with the delete cells box. Four options will be here: shift cells left, shift cells up, delete entire row, delete entire column. This is a column, so I want to delete it. Okay, so choose the option delete entire column, click on OK button, it is deleted. Got it? So we can add a row and a column, as well as we can add a column and delete a column. Adding rows and columns and deleting rows and columns. Clear? Okay, so what we studied so far now, how to add a table, right? In how many methods we can add a table? Three methods. What are they? Using the grid. Okay, using the grid. Then second method, insert table option. Okay, then third method, draw table option. Clear, students? That's good. Okay, now my question for all the students, those who know the answer loudly say. Okay, listen carefully. To insert a table, go to dash tab. I mean, which tab you have to go to? Do you need to go to home tab or insert tab or a page layout? Which tab you have to go? That is my question. That's good, students. Many of you come up with the answer. It is called insert tab. Okay, then which group I have to go? Good, it's we have to go to tables group, then table arrow. So you should remember three things: tab name, group name, then icon name, icon or arrow name. Okay, got it? That's good. Okay, so the next thing is how to make this tables more attractive. How to make it more attractive? Now it's like a black and white, right? It doesn't look good. Am I right? So shall we make it attractive? Yes. See, now my cursor, it's here. Okay, my cursor, it's outside the table. Now, do you see how many tabs are here? Total 8, including the office button. It is up to view we have. Okay. Now, let me click inside any one of the table. This one or this or here. Anyone, let me click here. Anywhere inside, click. When you click, do you see two more tabs are appearing? Design and layout. Design and layout. So from the name you can understand design. Design means we can design the table. Okay, let's see. When I click on a design table, okay, design, you can see table styles with colorful table formats. Okay, this is a more option. Click here, you can see many formats of tables. You can choose any one as you like. Okay, so which one I can choose, please tell me. Shall I choose this one? No. This one? No. See, this pista green looks attractive. I selected pista green. See, columns are hidden because that format, it's like that. If you want to change, click here again inside, go to design and try to change. Okay. So here it doesn't look good. I think let me click on more options. Okay. And I want to display the rows and columns clearly. Yes. Do you see? Alternatively, green and white, and you can see columns are also not erased. Clear? So this is a way you can make your table more attractive using which tab? Design tab and the group name table styles. Table styles, you have a many options, table formats. Click on more option, you will see many formats of tables. You can choose the one you like that will be applied to the table you selected. Clear, students? That's good. Now, let's see the next option, next feature in this table. See, our students, see here the break. Break is written in the first row of the table. Am I right? But this break, it belongs to Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, and all the days, right? So the break should be common for all these days. So we are going to make this break common for all these cells by using merging cells option. What is the option called? Merging. M-E-R-G-I-N-G. Merging cells option. Okay. So now do you see how many cells are here? This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So total 7 cells are here, right? So these 7 cells, I'm going to make it as a single cell. That is called merging. Merging means combining together. Got it? What does it mean by merging? Combining together is called merging. Okay. So select the cells first. So whatever you want to merge, first select it. Then go to layout tab. Then the group name is merge group. Then merge cells option. Click here. Now you can see all the cells are merged. Okay. Now you can just click on the break and you can put it wherever you need. So as I said, you can just using the enter key or backspace, you can go up or you can put it down. Okay. So this is called merging cells. Got it? Okay. So this is merging, as I said, combining cells. The another option is splitting the cells. Splitting means separating. Okay. For example, you can see the first cell, the first period timetable. Okay. I would like to display the time below that. Okay. So the first period starts from 8:30 to 9:10. So that I want to display here in the next line. So whatever the cells you want to split, click here. Okay. If I do it, you will understand. Okay. Click here. Then go to layout tab. Okay. Then merge group, the same group, okay, merge group, but the icon name it's split cells. Do you see here? Split cells. Click here. Okay, you can see split cells dialog box appears, which asks you how many rows and columns you want to split in this one particular cell. So this is a cell. I'm going to split this cell into how many columns? Columns means it's a vertical line, right? So I'm not going to make any column. So let it be one column. Okay. Then number of rows. rows, I need another row to enter the time. Okay, so total two rows I need. Okay, so click me OK button. Now, do you see the one cell? It's divided into two cells. Okay, is it clear? So this is one, and here I'm going to type the time, which is 8:30 to 9:10 is the first period. Okay, but it looks no, the time it's too bigger in size. So select the timing, go to home tab and change the size. Okay, so let me put it 6, then only it will become smaller. Understood? Okay, now this is the second one. So shall I do it again? So we are going to split this cell into two rows. Okay, so go to layout tab, split cells. Number of columns I need, it's 1. Number of rows I need, it's 2. Click on OK button. Now you have got it. You can type the time here. Clear, students? This is the way we merge cells and split cells. Got it? Okay. Now I would like to say few shortcut keys. Okay. See, now we are in page number 1, right? So I would like to go to next page. I do not want to type anything over here. And I would like to go to next page. So in order to go to next page, that means give a page break, you have to do Control plus Enter key on the keyboard. Now you have got a page break. So see the line, do you see a line here? That means the first page is over, second page starts over here. Okay, so this is the second page. If you want to create another table, click on the place where you want to add a table, then go to Insert tab, Tables Groups. Okay, using grids, you can select number of rows and columns as you like. You can create a table. So we are in the second page. Now, do you see page 2? When I just keep scroll down here, do you see page 2? It's displayed because we are in page 2. Okay, now if you want to go to the previous page, you have to press the shortcut key called F5 in the keyboard. Okay, so in the F5, it says the name of the box appears as Find and Replace. And if you see, you can see we are in a go to. So which page you want to go, or which section, or which line you want to go, bookmark, comment, footnote, everything it's here. So in order to go to a particular page or a section, we are pressing F5 key. See, in the page, I have selected the page, enter page number. I want to go to first page. So click on go to. See, we are in the first page. Now I want to go to second page. Okay, so let me close this. Let me do it again. So to go to another page or a section, which key we have to press? F5 in the keyboard. So I press the F5 key in the keyboard. Okay, so you have got a find and replace box, and here you can see page. Select the page and I want to go to second page. Click on go to button. We are in the second page now. Got it? Okay. So this is what we move to the pages. Okay. So to create a new page, which is Control plus Enter. Okay. Then to go to the page or a particular section, then F5 key. Is it clear for everyone? That's good, students. Then next shortcut key is, you want to save this page. I want to save this page because this is the one we have created, right? So how to save it? Normally we go to file tab and then save, right? Save or save us, right? So there is a shortcut key to do this, which is called, okay, F12, the function key F12. So press the F12 key, you will get a save us dialog box. Do you see the save us dialog box is here? Okay. So I'm going to save it, data drive 1, and I have created a folder for you. It's Mangai, and the table name is tables. Okay, I'm giving the name as table 1 .docx will be added automatically. Do you see? It is saved as table 1. Is it clear? That's good, students. Then the next shortcut key is to repeat the last comment what we have done. Okay, to repeat the last comment what we have done. Okay, say for example, now I'm typing just drawing table as we like. I have written as you wish, as you wish. Okay, I have changed one two words over here. Okay, so now I'm going to use another shortcut key F4 to repeat the last command. To repeat the last command, what is the last command I have given? You wish, right? I would like to repeat it again. Repeat the word you wish. So F4 key. You see? Okay, actually it has taken only you. Okay, so you wish. This is the last command I have given. Okay, so let me double click here, then press the F4 key. See, do you see you wish has come? Okay, again F4. See, actually I clicked on an enter key, that's the reason same again that line break is coming here. Okay, so clear students? So to repeat the last command, what we have done, we have to use the F4 key. Clear? That's good. So that's all the chapter. Students, we have studied, it's a very simple chapter. Okay, so in this chapter we have studied three ways of creating tables. Okay, method 1, 2 and method 3. So three ways of creating tables we have done. Then we have studied how to add rows and columns and delete rows and columns. Then resizing the rows and columns. Okay, the height and width, how to do it with the clicking and dragging we studied. Okay, then we studied about that merging cells and splitting cells. Okay, then some shortcut keys we have studied. So that's all the practical portion in this chapter. It's a too small chapter. I hope everyone understood how to create a table and make changes on it. Am I right? That's good, students. So read your text, and if you have a computer, work out whatever I taught. And if you have any doubt, please give a call back to me. Okay, send a message or call me back. Okay, if you send a message, whenever I see or whenever I'm free, I will reply back. Got it? Okay, students, I hope everyone understood how to create tables. That is three ways of creating tables in MS Word. Okay, so if you have a computer, please try to create a table in your home. All right, fine. Then it's a reminder, next Sunday we have a test paper from chapter 3. Okay, so everyone start prepare from today onwards. Saturday I'll send you a text message to remind you about the test paper. So do well in the test paper, which will be helpful for your term 1 exam. Got it? That's good, students. Also, whatever questions I'm sending, just to make a copy of it in the computer notebook itself, so that you can revise for the term exam. Otherwise, every time you have to, in a WhatsApp group, you have to go back and check the messages, or every time you have to go to the videos and see the video and pick up the questions. It's better when you watch at the same time itself, copy the questions in computer notebook itself. All right, students, stay home, stay safe, have a great day.